Hey everyone, so I wanted to do a video to talk about life after the big chop. So if you have recently BC'd or you are thinking about it, this video is for you. I wanted to talk about this because I know a lot of people who have just cut their hair off or who are still trying to determine if they want to cut their hair off. And I always like to encourage people, obviously it's your decision. Some people are very fearful of cutting their hair off and what it's gonna be like, especially if they've had long hair for their entire lives. Sometimes they can't imagine having short hair, which is totally understandable. You're used to having long hair, used to being able to throw it in a ponytail or doing whatever easy thing you do when you don't want to deal with your hair. So the idea of cutting all of it off and working with really short hair is sometimes very overwhelming for a lot of women, and I totally understand that. So I wanted to do a video to offer some encouragement and insight for women who are thinking about cutting their hair off or who have just recently done it and are kind of like, oh my gosh, what did I do? Now what am I gonna do? If you're feeling like that, first of all, understand that you are not alone, and it is a very natural feeling to have once you have BC'd. Taking that step to cut off your relaxed hair and start fresh with your natural hair is huge, 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 huge. So ladies, give yourself credit if you have recently done that or if you're thinking about doing it, because that is a big deal. It really is. And so you should be very proud of yourself. You should feel liberated and feel inspired, because the journey that you're about to embark on is going to be incredible. It's a totally new chapter in your life that I highly encourage you to embrace. Okay, so I guess the first thing to talk about when you cut your hair off is, and a lot of people don't think about this, and this is really, really critical for women who are newly natural. You have got to be comfortable with yourself, with who you are. When you cut your hair off, your face is prominent. Not that it's not prominent with long hair, but it immediately becomes a focal point. So ladies, if you have any type of insecurities about your face or your head, some people are really concerned about the shape of my head. Oh my gosh, the shape of my head is not gonna work with short hair. This journey, which starts with the big chop, encourages you and inspires you to really love who you are, who God made you to be. The way that He formed you is perfect. And you need to know that, and you need to embrace that. And this is the perfect time for you to do that. If you are holding back on starting your natural hair, well, not starting your journey, but if you're holding back from the big chop because you're concerned about, oh my gosh, it's gonna be all about my face and I'm uncomfortable with this feature or that feature, or oh, the shape of my head just is not gonna work out. First of all, you're your worst critic, okay? We as women are very critical of ourselves. It's natural. So what you are thinking is probably 10 times worse than it really actually is. So first, know that. But it's really the perfect time for you to love everything about this area of you, because natural hair, the big chop, brings out everything in this area. And you are beautiful. You got to know that. You've got to accept it. You've got to embrace it. You've got to believe it. Okay, nobody can believe it but you. So if you're struggling with any of those things, worrying about the features of your face and how a short haircut is going to work, or the shape of your head, or any of those physical type things, if any of those are holding you back, then I encourage you to start accepting yourself. Because when you cut your hair, this is you. This is part of you. And you need to love every piece of you. Every piece of you. So I encourage you ladies to do that. That is very, very, very important. And a lot of people don't go natural for these reasons that I'm talking about right now. Oh, I just won't look right natural, or whatever the case might be. And, you know, society has played a big part in that. But we as women, you know, we hold some level of responsibility in, you know, knowing that we are exactly as God created us. And we are beautiful. You are beautiful. So that's the first thing, is you got to know you're beautiful and embrace your beauty without your hair. If you've got long hair and you're beautiful with long hair, guess what? You're going to be beautiful without long hair, and your hair will grow back. So that's another thing to know. This is just temporary. This is not something that's going to, you know, hinder you for the rest of your life. I'm going to cut my hair and it's never going to grow back. No, you're going to cut your hair. You're going to love and learn your natural hair, and it's going to grow back probably faster and healthier than it ever has in your entire life. And that is an exciting thing to embrace. So you've got to know that and be comfortable with that. And you know, have faith that this isn't the end. This is not the end of the world. The big chop is not the end of the world. It really isn't. And you will be fine. And it's only temporary. This is not forever. It's only temporary. And you're going to learn so much about yourself, so much about your hair. You're going to be more bold. You're going to try different things that you probably wouldn't do in the areas of fashion and style, because why not? You've already cut your hair off. Might as well take another leap and do something different outside of yourself that you wouldn't typically do. This is a great opportunity that you should really be encouraged about. So that's the second thing, is knowing that it's temporary. Love yourself. Love you, with or without your long relaxed hair or whatever the case might be. Love who you are. Everything about you, get highly acquainted with it and love it. Learn to love it. Two, it's only temporary. It's not going to last forever. The third thing that I would say is that this is fun. It really is. And it can be if you allow it to be. Okay? It's something new in your life that you have to play with. And you have to deal with it lightly. Not so heavy. Okay? So when you cut your hair off, just as you had when you had relaxed hair, you're going to have bad hair days. It's inevitable. If you're a woman, you've experienced a bad hair day. Whether you're natural, relaxed, it does not make a difference. Those days are not going to go away. You will still have those days, but you're going to spend so much time learning about your hair texture, and you're going to spend so much time learning about how to maintain healthy hair, that you are going to become even more fierce than you were before this journey started. And it's a beautiful, beautiful thing. Okay? So I don't want you to get overwhelmed with the idea of, oh my gosh, my hair is natural. I have to use all natural all the time. No type of everything in the product has to be natural. I don't want you to get completely overwhelmed with products. And that is something that a lot of people are fearful of. You cut your hair, you want to grow healthy, natural hair. You don't want to put anything bad in it. Okay. Don't get so caught up in that. Okay. The fact that you have decided and made the decision to not relax your hair, to not put the chemicals in your hair that is literally stripping your hair, then that's the big thing. The products that the natural hair products that you use to maintain your natural hair, don't get so caught up in that. It's really, you'll be fine, okay? Educate yourself, gain as much knowledge as you possibly can, but don't get so caught up in the products. The products were fun for me. I was a product junkie. I love to try new things just because I had chopped my hair off. Why not try whatever I could to see how my hair, you know, reacted to the products. So don't get overwhelmed with products and, you know, knowing or not knowing what to use. You will figure it out. You will learn what works for you. This is fun. It's a fun experience. You just have to allow it to be. So many people take this so serious that it's a job and it becomes their, you know, it just becomes too much, completely overwhelming. And that is not what you want this to be. This is an awesome journey that you're on and you need to enjoy every minute of it. So make sure that you're having a good time as you learn your hair and you learn to love it. Because it really is a great experience. So you guys, I just want you to be encouraged and know that just because you've cut your hair off, you're thinking about cutting your hair off, that it's really going to be okay. You may feel like, oh my gosh, my hair is gone. You're fine. It will be okay. Trust me, it's going to grow back, and it's going to grow back so much faster than you thought it would. And just be encouraged and track your journey. Track your journey. It is so liberating and exciting to look back on your natural hair journey from where you started, from your big chop to wherever you are. And just to inspire and encourage you guys, I'm gonna put some photos at the end of this video from when I cut my hair off to, you know, kind of where I am now. And it is such a wonderful and incredible thing. So I just wanted to offer some encouragement to you guys who have recently BC'd or are thinking about doing it and are concerned about the things that I talked about. Don't be concerned. You're beautiful. Don't be concerned. It's temporary. It's gonna grow back. And have fun with it. Love it. Okay? You are beautiful and your hair is gonna be gorgeous. So there is life after the big chop. Despite what you might think, despite, you know, your worst nightmares, there is a life after the big chop. If you're thinking about it and haven't done it, don't be afraid to do it. It's liberating. And it's only temporary. That's probably the biggest thing. It's only temporary. Your hair is gonna grow back better than it ever was. Okay, you guys? So be encouraged, be inspired, and that's all I got. I'll talk to you guys next time. Bye. Got me up all night. All I'm singing is love songs. She got me up all night. Constant drinking and love songs. She got me up all night. Down and out with these love songs. She got me up all night. Drowning out with these love songs. She got me up.